Every joy in the life of this world is deficient if Iman is not in the equation. And similarly, every difficulty is manageable if Iman is present in the equation. And that is because Iman has a flavor. Imam Muslim narrates on the authority of Al-Abbas that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ضَاقَ طَعْمَ الْإِيمَانِ مَنْ رَضِيَ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ رَسُولًا. He who is pleased with Allah as his Lord and Islam as his religion and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as his prophet, he who is pleased with these things will taste the flavor of Iman. Iman has a flavor, la ilaha illallah. And Iman has a halawa, a sweetness. Imam Bukhari and Muslim narrate on the authority of Anas that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ بِهِنَّ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ. There are three attributes, whoever possesses them will taste the sweetness of Iman. What are they? Learn them. أَنْ يَكُونَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَاهُمَا. Number one, for Allah and His Messenger to become dearer to you than everything else. Number two, وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْأَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ. And to love another Muslim purely for the sake of Allah. وَأَنْ يَكْرَهَ أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أَنْقَذَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ كَمَا يَكْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. Number three, to hate to return to disbelief after Allah had saved you from it, the same way you hate to be thrown into fire.